Welcome to the video lecture on Maxwell's equations and electromagnetic waves. In this lecture, you are going to learn displacement current and Maxwell Ampere law, expression for displacement current, Maxwell's equations, electromagnetic waves, and wave equation for electromagnetic waves in vacuum. Now we will discuss why the correction is needed for the Maxwell's fourth equation obtained from the Ampere's circuital law and how the correction is applied. So the Ampere's circuital law is expressed as curl H is equal to J. Taking divergence on both sides, we have divergence of curl H is equal to divergence of J. But as per the rules of the vector analysis, divergence of the curl of any vector field is zero. So that is, the left side of this equation will be zero. So therefore, the divergence of J is equal to zero. So this conditions holds good for any electrical circuit with the current flow under static conditions only. For direct current in the circuit, such as one shown in the figure, if we consider a closed surface at some part of it, then we see that the charge flow into the surface is equal to the charge outflow from the surface. Therefore, the divergence J is equal to zero. But when you consider an AC circuit containing a capacitor, so consider a closed surface which encloses only one plate of the capacitor. It is clear that whenever there is any current flow into the closed surface, it is not accompanied by the simultaneous current outflow through any part of the surface. Thus, the condition divergence J is equal to zero fails in this particular case. So the equation divergence J is equal to zero is the equation of continuity for steady current, but for the time varying fields, the equation of continuity is divergence of J is equal to minus del rho V by del T. So therefore, it appears that Ampere's equation requires a modification. Thus, in order to rescue the equation of continuity, Maxwell introduced the concept of displacement current density. Introducing the concept of displacement current for a time-varying circuit, Maxwell suggested correction to the Ampere's law. According to Gauss' law, the divergence of D is equal to rho V. So differentiating the above equation with respect to time, so del by del T of divergence of D is equal to del rho V by del T. That is, divergence of del D by del T is equal to del rho V by del T. The equation of continuity is given by the divergence of J is equal to minus del rho V by del T. So from 1 and 2 we can write the divergence of J is equal to minus divergence of del D by del T. So from 1 and 2, so del divergence of J is equal to minus divergence of del D by del T. So therefore, the divergence of J plus del D by del T is equal to zero. So hence, for time varying circuits, divergence of J is equal to zero does not hold good, and instead divergence of J plus del D by del T is equal to 0 has to be used. Also, J in the Ampere's circuital law, that is curl H is equal to J, has to be replaced by J plus del D by del T. So thus the Maxwell Ampere's law is given by curl H is equal to J plus del D by del T. So this in the above equation, del D by del T is called the displacement current, and this is the fourth Maxwell's equation after correction. So now let us obtain the expression for the displacement current. Displacement current is the correction factor introduced by Maxwell in order to explain the continuity of electric current in the time varying circuits. It has the same unit as the electric current. Displacement current is associated with the magnetic field, but it does not describe the flow of the charge. So let us consider this particular parallel plate capacitor connected across an AC source. So let the area of each plate be A. Let the potential applied is V is equal to V naught into e to the power j omega t. The electric flux density D is given by D is equal to epsilon into E. Here E is the electric field strength, which is given by E is equal to V by T. Therefore D is equal to epsilon V divided by T. So now substituting for V from equation 1, we will get epsilon by D into V naught into e to the power j omega t. So the displacement current in terms of the displacement current density is given by ID is equal to del D by del T dot A. So that ID is equal to del by del T of epsilon by D into V naught into e to the power j omega t dot A. So executing the differentiation, the displacement current is given by ID is equal to j omega epsilon A divided by D into V naught into e to the power j omega t. So this gives the expression for the displacement current. List of four Maxwell's equations for time varying fields could be written as 1. From Gauss law of electrostatics, divergent of D is equal to rho v. 2. From Faraday's law, curl of E is equal to minus del B by del T. 3. From Gauss law of magnetic fields, divergent of B is equal to 0. 4. From Maxwell Ampere's law, curl of H is equal to J plus del D by del T. So these are the Maxwell's equations for time varying fields. Now the four Maxwell's equation for static fields could be written as Gauss law of electrostatics, that is divergence of D is equal to rho V, Faraday's law, curl of E is equal to 0, Gauss law of magnetic fields, divergence of B is equal to 0, and Maxwell Ampere's law, the curl of H is equal to J. So from time varying fields, we can see that is from the Faraday's law, curl of E is equal to minus del B by del T. So that means the varying magnetic field produces electric field. Similarly, from Maxwell Ampere's law, we can see that the varying electric field produces a magnetic field. So therefore, Maxwell's equations show that the time-varying magnetic field produces an electric field and time-varying electric field produces a magnetic field. The continuous interconversion of the field preserves them, and an electromagnetic perturbation propagates in space. Such fields are called electromagnetic waves. Such fields can exist independently without electric charges and currents. By combining the four electrodynamics equations, a wave equation was obtained which described the propagation of electromagnetic waves. So now let us obtain the wave equation for electromagnetic waves in vacuum. So let us consider four Maxwell's equations for time-varying fields. From Gauss law of electrostatics, divergence of D is equal to rho V. From Faraday's law, curl of E is equal to minus del B by del T. From Gauss law of magnetic fields, divergence of B is equal to zero. From Maxwell Ampere's law, curl of H is equal to J plus del D by del T. So let us obtain the equation for electromagnetic waves in vacuum. So let us consider two curl equations of Maxwell's. First one is curl of E is equal to minus del B by del T. And second one is curl of H is equal to J plus del D by del T. Now substituting for D and B, that is D is equal to epsilon into E, where D is the electric flux density, that is equal to epsilon is the permittivity of the medium and E is the electric field. And here B is the magnetic induction, H is the magnetic field and mu is the permeability of the medium. So substituting these in equation 1 and 2, so if you substitute B is equal to mu H in the equation 1, you will get curl E is equal to minus mu del H by del T. Similarly, curl H is equal to J plus epsilon into del E by del T. So you are substituting for D. D is equal to epsilon into E. So you will get this fourth equation. To derive wave equation in terms of electric field, the term H has to be eliminated. Taking curl on both sides, the equation 3, we will get curl of E is equal to minus mu into del by del T into curl of H. So that is taking the curl of E, this one. So that is equal to curl of this, that is nothing but minus mu into del by del T of curl of H. But from the vector identity we know that A cross B cross C is equal to B into A dot C minus C into A dot B. So thus we can write curl of E is equal to gradient of divergence of E minus del squared E. So just like this one. So as per Maxwell's equation, divergence of D is equal to rho V. Since D is equal to epsilon into E, it could be written as divergence of E is equal to rho V divided by epsilon. So substituting this one in this particular equation, so we will get, so curl of E is equal to gradient of rho V by epsilon minus del squared E. Substituting this equation in the equation 5, we will get, so gradient of rho V by epsilon minus del squared E is equal to minus mu into del by del T of curl of H. So substituting equation 4 in this equation 7, so we will get gradient of rho V by epsilon minus del squared E is equal to minus mu into del by del T of curl H is equal to J plus epsilon into del E by del T. So substituting here, you will get this particular equation. So the above equation could be rewritten as del squared E minus mu E into del squared E by
dt squared equal to mu into del j by del t plus gradient of rho v by epsilon. So the left hand side of this equation represents a propagating wave, and the right hand side of the source of origin of the wave. Here mu and e are respectively absolute permeability and absolute permittivity of the isotropic homogeneous medium. In the propagation of electromagnetic wave in free space, so j is equal to 0 and rho v is equal to 0. So substituting in equation 9, so we will get this j is 0 and rho v 0. So this side will be equal to 0. So therefore, the equation is equal to del squared E minus mu naught epsilon naught del squared E by dt squared equal to 0. So this is the electromagnetic wave equation for free space.